Hello, I'm Atuba George, and I'm so excited to be bringing God's truth to you. Now, this is a new week, and I'm going to be sharing some important thoughts with you from God's mind. Is it because He makes us know His mind? It's important everything you do, you pause to think, what's God thinking concerning this? And I've told you before, even when you want to pray, your first prayer should be, what does God want me to say? Now, what do you mean, what does God want me to say? What is on God's mind concerning this? Praise God. Let me show you a scripture in Isaiah 55. It says, verse 7. It says, let the wicked forsake his way, and the unrighteous man his thoughts. Let him return to the Lord, and He will have mercy on him, and to our God, for He will abundantly pardon. For my thoughts are not your thoughts, nor are your ways my ways, says the Lord. For as the heavens are higher than the earth, so are my ways higher than your ways, and my thoughts than your thoughts. Now, notice what God is saying. He said, let the wicked forsake his way, and the unrighteous man forsake his thoughts. See, the wicked man is known by his ways. The unrighteous man is known by his thoughts. You need to understand this. Now, God is saying, you who's a wicked man, in other words, you who's walking in the wrong way, do something, forsake your ways. Turn around from that way you have chosen. You know, scripture tells us that there is a way that seems right to a man, but the end of that way are the ways of death. Now, you need to understand this. There is a way, in other words, a pattern, a reasoning that looks right to a man, but the end of that reasoning, when you get, it's like a journey, you get to that junction on that journey, when you get to the end of that pattern, that thought, you get to a junction. And then at that junction, you see several roads. All of them are leading to death. That's not where you want to walk. Praise God. That's not where you want to walk. Now, that's why God is saying, let the wicked forsake his way. Forsake it. Notice, you know this is the way I want to take, but you know what? No. I'm turning away from it. See? Then he says, the unrighteous man should forsake his thoughts. So, the unrighteous man thinks in a particular way. And now he's saying, you know what? I'm fed up with thinking like this. I've got to stop. Now, that's where repentance comes in. I've told you before, that is the greatest gift and ability that God has given to his children. The ability to repent. Now, when they turn from their ways and their thoughts, where should they turn it to? He said, let him return to the Lord. See? Then God goes further and says, I have a way, and it's not man's way. I have a thought, and it's not man's thought. So when he says, forsake your way, he's not just saying, turn away from what you used to do. Turn away from it and to God's way. So there is God's way, and turn away from your thought to God's thought. So there is God's thought. See, concerning everything about your life, there is a way that God have chosen to do it. There is a way God thinks about it. When it comes to blessing you, there is a way God thinks about blessing you. When it comes to just anything, there is a way. And that's why the scripture has been given to us. The Bible has been given to us. So we can study and understand the patterns of God. So we read God did this in Abraham. He did it in Isaac. He did it in Jacob. Oh, that means this is how God thinks. Or this is how God's ways are. Praise God. Now listen, I'm going to be sharing with you this week, because there's something the Lord have laid in my heart to share with you this week. And that's something the Lord told us in the month of May. And he said, you know, in Malachi chapter 2 from verse 17, God is speaking here, and he says, you have wearied the Lord with your words, yet you say, in what way have we wearied him? In that you say, everyone who does evil is good in the sight of the Lord, and he delights in them. Or where is the God of justice? Now, This is what a lot of people are thinking. This is the challenge in a lot of people's mind. What is it? God says, you've weighed me. Notice, I'm tired of hearing that. Now, that's what the Spirit of God is saying. He says, I'm tired of hearing that. Hearing what? That everyone, well, why does it look like it's the bad guys that are making it in life? Why does it look like, I mean, me that said I'm going to do things properly, me that said I'm going to do things righteously, I mean, I'm finding it difficult. But the bad guys are the ones making waves. The bad guys are the ones making money. Wherever you find yourself, have you thought about this before? Have you thought like this before? See, I mean, have you asked this question before, even if it's in your heart? But, I mean, why is it that is the you know, even ladies say, why is it that it's the bad girls that are getting married easily? Me that have kept myself, I'm still here praying, but, I mean, that bad person want to, you know, this one I know that been jumping from one relationship. Same thing with the guys. I mean, I'm trying to do my business in an honest manner. Everybody's just, I'm just hooked everywhere. But the bad guys are just the ones, you know, they bribe here and they've gotten the job. They. Now God says, you, my child, have wearied me with those words or with those thoughts. Now, the last question says, where is the God of justice? Praise God. Now, tomorrow, I'm going to show you God's response to this question. Praise God. Listen, it's going to be an exciting time. You're going to learn. You're going to increase. You're going to be established in righteousness as these words are coming forth. I just bless you this week. And I declare that the Spirit of God is resting upon you, cleansing your heart and your mind from every evil, and bringing your heart to become one with God's thoughts and in God's ways. Thank you, Holy Spirit, because that's what's happening in everyone watching and listening to me right now. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. Until tomorrow, this is Atuba George. Step out there and have a wonderful day. Bye-bye.